with all the Swedish dairy products and gluten products. I realized that when I became vegan at 15, it disappeared. About half disappeared. And because mainly my diet was cooked. Then I got on raw food later on and it totally disappeared. So this change of going on to a vegan raw food diet definitely is gonna make you so happy. I started to clean my colon and took supplementation like digestive enzymes, more probiotic, which will help you tremendously. But you know, just to become a vegan and maybe eat lots of soy product, which is heavy in phytoestrogens for you, it's not gonna help you. You need to get on a cleaner diet and much more raw food. When it comes to endometriosis, it is a uterus growth, and the inflammation responds so well here to the raw food diet and douches. We use wheatgrass. Of course, we drink 2 ounces of wheatgrass juice twice a day, and then we can do a douche for a few months. Like every other day, we can take a little syringe and mix half wheatgrass with half water. And we can even add digestive enzymes. We can tap the powder into that and get more. We can put probiotics too into that douche and take it every other day, once a day. And that has been enormous help for women. But you know, the bottom line is that you, you know, you change your lifestyle, change diet. I hope you exercise. I hope you drink enough fluids and get organically grown foods. The problem is many times with inflammations of any kind is that our body is so acidic that inflammation happens. So we want to be on an alkaline diet. The green juices we make here that has sunflower sprouts, pea sprouts, celery, cucumber is enormously good to that. Wheatgrass juice, of course, is super alkaline. Blue green algae, all kinds of algae, like green algae, blue green algae, we use many different forms of them, has been great help for you. So, you know, get onto an alkaline diet, get onto the raw.